Like hound, chihuahua, and reindeer.
So like gay and gay, rainbow, rainbow.
How are you?
You know what? I'm actually thriving in quarantine.
You are correct. We have been upgraded. We have Egan to thank for that. His online name is Egan El Rancho. I'll post his boop boops in the description so you can follow him. He's absolutely incredible. You'll also see some of his transitional work sprinkled throughout this episode. And by the way, on behalf of myself, Paul Flanagan, Jeremiah Brown, Cassi, Kohl over in Seattle, we welcome you to the Sands of Aldea Sunsing Cabaret. To start this off, a huge thank you to everybody who donated for Give Big. We love you so much. We cannot do this without your support. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. If you missed it, don't worry about it. You can donate anytime, any day on our website. I know. Isn't that so convenient? So, on today's adventure, song-wise coming at ya, we have the Lauren Duprat, the Jessi Little, and then an original by Darnell White. It's real good. Interview-wise, Cassi Kohl sat down with SJ Henley-Hicks and Dustin Durham, and then I sat down with Sara Porkalob. Now, if you follow us on the social medias, you'll notice that I already posted a little chunk of Sara Porkalob's interview. I mean, hashtag wisdom. Like, we all know how amazing Sara is. So go check that out. And for the full interviews, go to our Instagram. We're doing the IGTV. We're not posting those full interviews on the Facebook, just the Instagram. So go there and watch it. Is there anything else? I'll address that after. Thank you so much. Without further ado, this is the Sands of Aldea Stinson Cabaret Egan Transition.
On olives from the fridge, we stood alone every day. We made love all afternoon till the stars went blue. You wrote a ballad, we dined on oysters and champagne. That's what it seemed like. We connect in so many ways, so easy, I must say. Why am I so shy around you? Why am I so shy? Why do I take care to astound you? Why do I even try? Another rainy day, we sat inside by the radiator watching old black and white films where everybody sang. You played in my solitude, didn't get dressed till 2.
Typical day.
The rain says all. I wrote the song on my guitar. It didn't turn out right, so we just connected in other ways. So easy, I must say. my soul shy around you? Why am I so shy? Why do I take care to astound you? Why do I even try? Why am I so shy? Why do I take care? Why am I so shy? So shy, I'm so shy, I'm so shy. I'm shy, so shy. I'm shy, I'm shy. I'm shy. You're not. You don't exist. I'm alone in quarantine.
Oh my gosh, you look amazing. You truly look like you're in a magical woodland fairy land.
You know, I gotta comfort myself some way, and so I decided to turn my bed area into a tent, which is very magical and beautiful.
Introduce yourself for the people who don't know you.
Oh, hello. My name is Sara Henley-Hicks, or SJ Henley-Hicks. My pronouns are they, them, and I like to party.
Your quarantine hair is fire. It's so
Thank
good.
You. It was an accident. I was trying to go blonde and forgot that I had put red hair dye in my hair a couple, like, months ago. Apparently, the red didn't come out, and so now I'm a, you know, strawberry lemonade.
It is so cool. Like, your whole vibe right now is very, like, gay Lisa Frank. I mean, I think that's a little redundant, actually.
Gay Lisa Frank. So, like, gay and gay, rainbow, rainbow.
Like, gay, gay, rainbow, rainbow, double. Double.
Also, nice rack behind you.
I know. One of my very good friends gave it to me. Beep, beep,
beep, beep, beep, beep, beep, beep, beep. Titties in the window.
For the listeners out there, SJ brought pickled red onions to our doorstep in a boobs bag.
Everything's better in a boobs bag.
Have you done anything that you've been putting off during this quarantine time?
I would say kind of. So I've been like more and more like organizing my room. I guess like putting up a tent didn't really help, but been like organizing my room and like getting rid of more stuff or like putting it aside so I can take it to Goodwill once everything opens back up. Yeah. And then like me and my roommate are trying to redo our kitchen kind of. So I've been like slowly upgrading things there, and we're going to like sand down some things and paint some things. And my big thing though I need to do is clean out my closet, and I've been putting that off since before quarantine. So it's gonna happen before the end of the month, which is hopefully when, you know, the quarantine ends. But I mean, who knows?
Who knows? Those are big steps. Like the spring cleaning quarantine edition is very real. It's very real. Amazing to go through the little corners and be like, huh. Well, I love you, SJ. You're magic.
I love you, too. Me, 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 me. I love you, Sensible Cabaret.
Yay!
Theater Company.
Bye.
Bye, babe.
What a time for technology. So, hi, Dustin.
Hello.
Hello. Please introduce yourself to the people at home.
Hello. My name is Dustin. I'm a Pisces. I'm living in Seattle. I'm a freelance dancer and burlesque performer. And that's me.
That's you. That's beautiful. Where are you in Seattle? What neighborhood are you in again?
Right now I'm in Leschi, but I'm actually moving down to Des Moines next week.
Ooh.
Yeah.
A country girl.
Yes. Getting myself a house.
Oh, that's so exciting. Good for you.
Yeah.
More space.
Really happy about it. More space, a garage, a yard.
Oh, that's awesome. Oh, good for you. Exciting.
Mm-hmm. Go outside, churn some butter.
My beautiful one, I loved your video when I heard I was like, oh, this is it.
A little Alexis.
Choreography was fire. I loved it so much.
I was so just, happy. This crazy time we're in. It was either do something really silly or do something really like sad girl cry.
Oh, that's wonderful. What kind of dog do you have?
I don't know. We don't know exactly what he is. My roommate adopted him when she was in high school. But he's somewhere of a mix of some sort of like hound, chihuahua, and reindeer. He can freaking fly. Like, I'm 6 feet tall and he can like jump to here. And he's only about yay big. He's insane.
So he has not been drafted by Santa yet to join that squad.
Keyword yet.
Yay, so what have you, so other than like waiting for Schitt's Creek to come out on Netflix, like what have you been seeing recently that's super funny?
When this first thing started, we decided to, me and my roommate, to start binge watching America's Next Top Model from season one. And now we've been in the house for about a month and a half straight. We're on season 8. It's quite the commitment, but we are going for it.
I feel like somebody should know about this, and you should get a medal for it when you get through the
I'll just call Tyra.
It's like, oh, hello.
Yes, hello, Mrs. Banks.
Mrs. Banks, you're magical. Thank you so much for submitting that amazing
dance. Of course, this is so much fun.
Yes, and how can we follow? Are you teaching any classes or?
I'm not teaching right now. I'm just taking. But I've often been posting on my story a lot of random things. Like yesterday, I did dance church and I ended up dancing on top of my countertop by myself in my kitchen. So that was a fun thing that was on there. But it's just Dustin Durham with an underscore on Instagram. And you can find everything else from there. But perfect. That's me. Yeah.
Yay. Perfect, Dustin. You are very loved. You're magical. We will talk to you.
I love you guys.
Soon, I'm sure.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye.
I try to think about Elvis, Memphis. Upper in the afternoon, I try to think about palm trees, fig leaves, the creature from the black lagoon. I try to think about high heels and good deals, anything to get me through. I just can't concentrate. COVID's all I think about these days. I try to contemplate the cosmos, what goes round around the sky at night. I try to focus on champagne, freight trains slowly rolling out of sight. I don't focus on them headlines or street crimes, anything I think I might. I just can't concentrate. COVID's all I think about these days. My mind wonders where it will. Should say, I forget what I should do. I might wonder where it will when it settles on the flu. I forget what I should say. I try to focus on Shakespeare, leap year, the Beatles or the Rolling Stones. I try to think about hairdos, tattoos, sushi bars and saxophones. I try to think about talk shows, new clothes, but I guess I should have known. I just can't concentrate. Yeah.
called There You Are by Darnell White. Me. There you are, standing there, loving me when I am down. You are. There you are, speaking loud when I cannot make a sound. You have given me peace in a mind that's at war. You've shown me world, you're all that I live for. I love you, I do. But I just don't seem to know. You have given me peace in a mind that's at war. You've shown me the world, you're all that I live for. And I love you, I do.
The dragon herself.
Rawr. Why am I a cat right now? Rawr. Okay.
Yeah. How are you?
You know what? I'm actually thriving in quarantine. I'm gonna be very honest. Like, thanks to a lot of privilege that I have financially, mentally, even my geographical location, like where my apartment is, I'm really enjoying this time as a moment to like reflect on kind of the last 8 years of my professional life and my personal life, and really appreciating the slowdown for myself, you know, and acknowledging that like not everybody is feeling the same way. So yeah, being honest, yeah, I feel like I'm thriving thanks to my privilege. So thanks for asking.
Well, it's also your wisdom and your correctness too. Which...
Thanks, Paul. Pisces energy.
I love that you are owning that and that you're just saying yes to the energies of Corona.
Ayo.
Let's expand upon that a little bit. How would you explain self-reflection and self-growth to someone who has never been successful at doing it? I know, it's a great question.
Yeah, I think... In order to answer it like in full, we'd have to have a longer time to chat. The first step is acknowledging that for most of us, our American society and specifically our educational systems, aka like where we go to learn how to be people, don't facilitate this type of introspection, because our socialization doesn't facilitate it. It is difficult to even begin. That first step of acknowledgement, this like, oh, I've never done this thing. And actually, it's not going to be easy for anybody to do, because we are, as Americans, right, socialized under similar and different and intersectional conditions. So recognizing that step, first and foremost, that it's like, whoop, it's not a linear path. It's actually a new way of thinking about yourself, which will change how you see the world and yourself and the people around you continually. It suddenly becomes deeper and wider, and it breaks away from this like A to B linear way of thinking about your path and yourself in a way that I think is beautiful and challenging. And one thing that's helped me get through the difficulty of step one, which never goes away, like right when I think I've learned something important about myself, I like have to unlearn so much more.
Yeah.
I'm just you know what I mean? But I'm like, the thing that gets me through it is like, oh, what a wonderful privilege and blessing that I actually get to do this for myself. And in turn, maybe by sharing how I do this for myself and asking others how they do that for themselves and receiving and listening, we can together create new strategies for a different type of cultural understanding of the individual within a community. That's my hope. And that's how like I approach my work, is it truly starts with the individual, but the individual does not exist in a vacuum.
Well said.
Thank you.
Talk to us about the amazing things that are coming up. We have Broadway.
Ostensibly. So it has been announced that the revival of the 1969 musical 1776, about the signing of the Declaration of Independence, is heading to Le Broadway next spring, 2021. And your girl is in it. And in the event that it still happens, fingers crossed, I, along with 23 other incredible female-identifying trans and non-binary artists and performers and activists, will be bringing to life the story of the Founding Fathers in like February in New York of next year, like right around Inauguration Day. And now just in a place, you know, I can share, like I've been told that I can share, is like we're not quite sure what the next step is. I think that ART, Diane, our director, Diane Paulus, who's the AD over there, as well as our producing partners, they are paying attention to the national orders around COVID-19. It is tantamount to them to protect our safety, not only our safety, but the safety of our audience and community. And I admire and respect them for that. So there's a part of me, obviously, that wants to go to Broadway, of course. And there's a part of me that understands that if it doesn't happen, then we've done the right thing. It's an interesting like piece I've come to with that.
Thank you.
Thanks, Paul.
Thank you for sitting down. Thank you for sharing your wisdom. Thank you for existing and being your correct, beautiful self. Your song was absolute perfection.
Did you like it?
Oh, girl, yes.
Mama.
Hello, rainy days, boob bags, reindeer, Jessi Little playing the piano, Sara Porkalob as cat, Darnell, I want to be wherever you are. Okay? Okay. That was a good episode. Isn't our community amazing? I mean, where else can you see LGBTQIA+ and allied individuals? Hashtag thriving. Come on now. Y'all, we're gonna continue this now that we're looking cute and snazzy. Wasn't Egan's stuff cool? So, let us know if you want to sing, do a dance, talk to us. We have all the opportunities. Send us an email, thrive@sensibletheatre.co, no M, just C-O. Follow us on all the socials, share this with all of the friends. Go on over to the Instagram to watch the full interviews. And if you haven't seen it, go watch that teaser clip that I shared with Sara. Oh, the elephant in the room. Yes. I do have my hair in a ponytail. I know it's not cute. I need help. I can't wait to get a hair shape. We love you. Thank you for watching this. You're not alone. Go do something that makes you smile. Let's continue the love. Okay? This was the Sands of Old Dias dancing cabaret. Goodbye.